In this problem, we've got a golf ball being launched from ground level. I'm going to put the origin right where the ball starts. So that's the point at which x and y are both equal to 0. I'm given an initial speed on this launch of 45 meters per second and an angle of inclination of 52 degrees. So before I start doing anything, I'm going to break the velocity into components. So that vertical component just comes from translating this vertical leg of the right triangle that you can break the original velocity into. So in other words, that magnitude is equal to the magnitude of the dashed line that I just drew. So my x velocity component, that's v naught x. Well, that corresponds to the adjacent side of this thing. So it's going to be hypotenuse times the cosine of the angle 45 cosine 52 degrees. And when I run the numbers on this, I've got 27.7 meters per second. The y component corresponds to the vertical leg of that right triangle, and so I get v naught y is equal to 45 sine of 52 degrees using the sine function because I'm trying to grab the opposite side of the right triangle to the angle that was labeled. And I get 35.5 meters per second for the y component of the velocity. In part A, I'm asked to get the flight time for the projectile. And so the way to get a handle on this is to ask, what do I know at the end of the flight? Is it something about x or something about y? And in this case, it's something about y. Y is equal to 12 meters. I'm told that this is an elevated surface 12 meters above the starting point. So given that I have this little bit of extra information about y, that's how I'm going to attack the flight time problem. Now remember, the equations of motion for the vertical and horizontal directions can be unlinked and just written down separately. In the y direction, there's an acceleration of negative g. In the x direction, there's no acceleration at all. So I'm going to take my standard kinematics formula, but instead of plus 1/2 at squared at the end, I'm going to plug in negative g for the acceleration. And there's my starting point. Now my final y position is 12. My initial was 0. My initial y velocity, probably should have labeled it that way, is 35.5. The flight time is unknown. Plug in g equals 9.8. And we have a quadratic equation to solve. So I'm going to move all the terms to the left-hand side, mostly because I'd like to have a positive 4.9. I like to have a positive a for the quadratic formula. My preference is to just use technology to grind through this and find the value of t. However, sometimes we're required to do this by hand, so I'll illustrate what that looks like. So I'm appealing to the quadratic formula here. T is negative b, that's 35.5, plus or minus square root b squared, 35.5 squared, minus 4 times a times c, all divided by twice a, which is 9.8. And I'll simplify the square root down to a decimal. And I get 32.0 for that. So 35.5 plus or minus 32.0 all divided by 9.8. So we'll go ahead and plug in the minus sign version and the plus sign version and simplify them both down to a number. I'm doing the minus first, 35.5 minus 32 all divided by 9.8. And I've got a time of 0.357 seconds. Then I plug in the plus version, 35.5 plus 32 divided by 9.8, and I've got 6.89 seconds. So I have to ask, which one of these is the one I'm going to keep? Both of them are physical solutions. They both happened in reality. And I have to think, like, what did I plug into the mathematics here? And what I plugged in was a 12 for the height, and I said, tell me what time it is. And by the time I solve the equations, I get two times. The reason why is because back here, the golf ball was at a height of 12 meters on its way up. So that's all this small time solution means, but we're not interested in it. The flight terminates at 6.89 seconds. Finally, we're asked to get the range for the projectile. That means the horizontal displacement for the flight. And this part is simple by comparison. The x motion of a projectile is just a constant velocity motion because there's no forces acting left or right on it, only straight down from gravity. So there's no x acceleration, at least when we're ignoring the effects of air resistance. My initial x position was 0. My initial x velocity I've already taken care of. That was 27.7 meters per second. I've got the flight time, 6.89 seconds. And I come out with a range of 191 meters for this golf shot. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.